Hi everyone, Henry here. Hope you are doing great. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Nero Game Engine 2 demo. I will show you how to download and install the engine. Then, we are going to create our first project. If you never heard of the engine, it's an XFML 2D game engine that works like Unreal or Unity 3D. That said, let's get started. You can download the engine on the engine website. Simply search Nero Game Engine in your browser. If you want, you can also go directly to nerogame.com. The link is in the description. On the download page, you will see Nero Game Engine D2.0.1. Click on the button here and download the engine. I already downloaded the engine. I got it on my desktop, so let's install it. The installation is almost completed. Okay, let's open the engine now. The first time you open the engine, you will see that pop-up. It's called the configuration wizard. Basically, the engine is telling you to make some configuration before you can start using it. Here we have three things to do: configure a code editor, configure texture packer, and create a workspace. I click on next to continue. For the code editor, you have a choice between Qt Creator and Visual Studio 2019. For this tutorial, I'm going to configure both. But you only need one. You can follow the link in the wizard and download Qt. On Windows, it's almost 4 GB. I already have it, so let's make the configuration. The same thing with Visual Studio, follow the link to download it. I use the latest preview of the community version. I already installed it, so I'm just going to make the configuration. Well, I don't remember the path. Let's check that. I think it begins with an E. Okay, it's a D. There it is. Again, the same thing here, follow the link and download Texture Packer, install it and give the path to the engine. I'm going to create a new workspace on my desktop. Let's call it I don't know, Mirror Game Engine tutorial. Mirror Games. I put my name here. NG. Congratulations! You now have a proper environment. That's great. Let's close the wizard now. So everyone, this is the Neuro Game Engine 2. In the next part, I'm going to show you how to create your first project. First, you need to open the Project Manager window. You do that with the button Project here. Go to the Create Project tab by clicking here. You can also use the button Create New Project. Let's name the project Project 01. There are some rules for the project name. You cannot have a number at the beginning. If I put 5 here and try to create the project, I will get the error invalid project name. We have our workspace created earlier. Normally there are 3 types of project, but this is a demo. I have 2 options for the code editor because I configure both. If you have chosen between Qt and Visual Studio, it will be your only option here. The other parameters, project lead, company and namespace, are filled automatically. Let's add a description before to create the project. What the engine is doing now is to generate and compile your project. It takes a little bit of time, so let's wait a few seconds. The compilation is completed. Let's open the project now. The first thing you can notice when a project is open are the buttons on the toolbar. If you have a small screen, you won't be able to see all of them. In this case, you can scroll the toolbar with the buttons that appear on the edge, or if you want, you can use your mouse wheel. Before we continue, I want to show you how to open a project you have already created. I'm going to close this project and show different ways to open it. As you can see, the buttons on the toolbar just disappeared. In the Recent Projects tab within the Project Manager, we can see our project. Click on the Open Project tab or use the button here and you will see all your projects. The projects are organized by workspace. Use the button Open Project to open one. Finally, if you go to the menu File, then Recent Projects, you will see our project 01. Now let's reopen the project and continue where we left. The editor should have popped up now. I don't understand, let's try to force it. So I'll get it below here. The first time you open a project with Qt, you'll need to import your project build. Uncheck everything and go to Import Build From. As you can see, Qt tries to find your build automatically. The path is not quite exact, just chance here to build, and that's okay. This is not a good method. Let's do that correctly. So I click on browse and then I go to my desktop. In our workspace there is a folder projects. Inside we have our project 01. Here you can see the folder build. That's what we want to import. The path is okay. Now let's click on configure project. You can see the code generated by the engine, which means that everything is okay. If you cannot see the code, don't panic, it's normal. You need to configure CMake first. If you are wondering what is CMake, it's a build tool. It makes code compilation easier. The engine comes with CMake, we just need to tell Qt where to find it. Go to Project, then Manage Kits. Here you can see CMake. I already got a configuration. Let's remove it and create a new one. Let's put Nero Game CMake here. You can write whatever you want. Now we need to find where CMake is. Let's locate the engine installation folder first. If you do open file location on the start menu, you find a link. Let's do a right click and open file location again. This is the engine editor folder. Let's go two folders back so you can see more clearly. Here you have tool, then CMake. Inside bin, this is the file we want. I'm going to copy this path and go back to Qt. Then I'm going to make the configuration. You can override the changes here. Everything seems fine, so let's click on OK. Go to the project, right click and do run CMake. You should be able to see the code now. Let's do a final test. I'm going to compile the project and see if it's work. You can use the button here or use the shortcut Ctrl B. Everything is okay, the build works. Let's get a look at the code. Here you have a class with your project name plus the world scene. It's your main class. You have a constructor, a destructor, and a few methods. Don't worry if you don't understand any of that. I'm going to explain all of it in a future video. That's all for this tutorial. If you have any question, please leave a comment. If you find this tutorial useful, leave a like and subscribe for more videos. Until next time, take care of yourself.